Okay, we're starting out with some dashboard work here on Eleanor today. There's a whole bunch of holes down on the bottom here. A lot of these holes I don't think belong here stock, and looks like the radio hole has just been butchered, and I don't know what the hell happened over here. They drilled a hole into a hole and made a mess. This is typically where the key switch goes, but I don't think I'm going to use it for that anymore. This hole, I'm not even for certain what that is. I don't care, it's going away. So we're gonna patch up all these holes in the dashboard here, with the exception of the speaker hole and of course the speedometer hole. The speedometer hole is still gonna get filled with a speedometer. The speaker hole still might get a speaker. I don't know what I'm gonna do in here. I might even get really crazy and custom and have this little thing fold down somehow. And I'll do a little trim work here and drop a little tablet or something behind it. I think that'll be kind of cool. But it'll look stock or stock-ish when you put the grill back on it. So that was kind of the idea that I had, but I don't know, we'll see. These are ideas that I'm just kind of kicking around because this is trim stuff. Once again, trim. But filling these holes in must be done before it goes to Earl for paint. If you haven't been to Earl's channel already, duckshit.net/CCC, you'll check him out, because when this car goes over there, he's gonna do all the final bodywork and painting on it. And when it rolls back out, she's gonna be gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. And I can't wait to see exactly how this thing is going to turn out. So anyway, if you want to know the color reveal, again, you'll have to be up on Earl's channel just the same. But after we get done with this, we got to do a little bit of fill elsewhere on the body, but we'll get to that when we get to it. Meanwhile, let's go ahead and get this patched up. Welcome back to Duckman Cycles and VW Garage. I'm your host, the Duckman. We're back today with my 1956 Beetle, also known as Eleanor. And as you saw from the beginning of the video, I went ahead and patched up that dashboard. I filled in all the holes that are in there, and I've coated it with a nice coating of cat piss, which is phosphoric acid, by the way. It should be good to go from here. So that way, when I get the car back, I'll be able to drill the holes wherever I want to put them and install vintage-looking switches. The ivory, they're plastic, by the way. I've called them ivory, and everybody's trying to tell me how to get genuine ivory knobs. No, the Volkswagen ones that belong on here are actually ivory-colored plastic. And I'd like to install a whole bunch of vintage switches across it for all my different little doohickeys and gadgets. And it's going to be different than stock. I don't plan on putting a stock radio back in or a stock-like radio back in. I want the vintage look, but I don't want that crap. I just want everything to be accessible. Right there in the center console, I think, is the best place to do it. So the dashboard is now patched up, and I can put the holes wherever I want for my switch panel. And I think I'll probably make a really, really nice escutcheon, maybe out of stainless steel or something. And I'll cut the holes wherever the switches need to go through, and I'll put the whole thing over it and make it look just nice, like it was something that Volkswagen made at the factory, because that has always been the purpose of why I've been cutting up this car and what I'm trying to do on it. I want everything to look custom but stock, you know, coach built, as if this car was originally built at a limited edition Volkswagen factory. They took a bunch of these, they made a bunch of modified ones, and only four of them were created. Most of them stayed in Germany, but one of them went down to Argentina where Hitler lived, and he drove it himself until the day he died. It's a whole bunch of horseshit story, but I like sharing it. And when I go to the car shows and I tell the people, they buy the story. It's absolute crap, but it's fun. Anyways, nonetheless, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, pluck that dinglebelly. That way you get updates every time that I upload a video. And check out duckshit.net/store. That's right, you too can be purchasing some merch. I've got a whole bunch of these right now. I didn't want to put them on again today because, well, I keep saying it. I bought extras and I did. I've got about a dozen shirts for me now. But I just can't bring myself to wearing them in the shop. Good old Mike. I love you, good old Mike. Check out good old Mike if you haven't already. Goodoldmike.com is his website. He's also got a YouTube/goodoldmike, I believe it is. He got a white Duckman Cycles and VW Garage t-shirt. And I still can't believe it, but he posted it up and that boy got dirty wearing it. So he broke in his Duckman Cycles and VW Garage shirt, probably the best way he could. And I'm so complimented that he actually went out in the shop in his shirt and proudly wore it. But I don't know, I can't bring myself to do it. Especially not this gray one. I don't know why, but for some reason I got two in XL, a gray one and a black one, and the gray one fits better. So for those of you that, you know, want to pick different colors, or for those of you that are around my size, you might want to pick a gray one. I don't know. I kind of like the way it looks too. It's kind of neutral. You know, black is dark, white is white, and gray is kind of somewhere in between, and that's a little more me anyway. But yep, it worked out good. Anyways, as always, guys, I said it once before, like, comment, subscribe, pluck that dinglebelly, and stick around. Got lots more to go on this car, and I made some progress also in the rear hatch area. There was a whole bunch of pinholes back there, and actually, they weren't pinholes. Some of the welding, after I did the grinding, the shit fell through so badly that I had slots. I mean, I could have slipped a silver dollar into some of these slots. So I patched all that up, and I put in the catches also for the rear hatch, so that way when you turn the little levers, it locks the thing down just like on a bus. In fact, they're from a bus. And I'm looking at it right now. I threw phosphoric acid all over the whole damn thing, and it turned out good. I put about, you know, another hour or so into that. I need to finish patching the rear pop-out window motors. There's a couple little welds that still need to be made in there, so I got to play with that a little bit. And after that, I did notice that on the B pillar, I don't know how I didn't notice this before, but when you close the door, the B pillar actually is struck by the door when it hits its maximum closing, and they're not supposed to rub. So I gotta put a little cut in there and make some clearance. And I also forgot that there's a reinforcement that goes into the B pillar for the seat belts that go over the shoulder. And I never put them back in. So that's one of those things I also have to remember. And I gotta straighten that out too. In addition, when you tap on the outside of the C pillar on the passenger side, you probably remember it hits the box on the inside. So I'm going to drill a little hole through it where it hits and weld them together, so that way they're solid one piece. So when you tap on it, it won't make any such noises, and there'll be no chance of vibration of the two panels rattling together while we're driving. Otherwise, things are coming together great. I mean, I'm doing a whole lot of this, but I need to just keep on working on this thing. After that, we need to hit the A pillar over here, finish welding in the hinge pocket, cover up the old hinge pockets for the stock hinges, and fill up the last couple of holes that are here in the B pillar also and get that squared away. But things are going together well. There's really no gotchas at this point. It's just a matter of just making some little patches and just taking my time doing it, making everything look nice and getting it ready for Earl. In the next 2 weeks, I'll have Eleanor over in Earl's shop, and Earl's gonna do all the final coat work on this car, the final paint, whatever color it is that I finally do choose, he will be revealing it. So you need to subscribe to Earl's channel. I can't stress that enough. Go to duckshit.net/CCC. That will forward you directly to Earl's channel. I give you Earl's channel URL, but it's like really long with a whole bunch of letters. And it's really easy to remember, duckshit.net/CCC. Boom, that'll take you right to his YouTube. When you hit it, subscribe, ring his little dingle belly, and make sure that you stick around with him. He's got like 450-ish subscribers right now. He needs to have more. I mean, geez, I'm rolling over 22,000 this weekend. I still can't believe it myself. So we need to have 22,000 people go over to Earl's channel and subscribe to him. Otherwise, you will not be seeing what color Eleanor is. And you guys are going to be asking, hey, what happened to your Beetle? Why aren't you posting any more updates? Well, I've said it in almost every video for the last 90 days. You got to go over to Earl's channel. You got to subscribe. Duckshit.net/CCC. I can't stress it enough. Otherwise, you're going to miss out on what happens in this project. Anyways, let's keep on welding. Let's keep on this project. Let's try to get as much done as possible before it gets dark. I'm making some really, really good headway. I'm taking care of all the last big things that are going to be issues. And after that, it's just a matter of, you know, just a little grinding here and there and a little patch, a little pinhole, really simple stuff. And then after that, I got to figure out how we're getting this to Earl's place. So that's one of my next things that we'll get to that and we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. You guys are going to be the first to know. Once it happens, of course, we'll record a video and we'll get it uploaded. Thanks for watching, guys. Really appreciate it. Let's stay on this thing and we'll see you in a few minutes. So anyways, we're back. We're still welding on this this car. It needs lots of little things that need to be cared for. So we're gonna keep on it. But before I started back on that, I wanna mention that my blue cup here, which is just a rum and a cola once again, it's actually a ginger cola with an orange rum. And oh my God, it's good. We're gonna give a little video up on VV the Duck VV over on my other YouTube channel of how we make what I call ginger bombshells. These are primo, really, really good. Really excellent too, if you have a lady over, they just freaking love these things. And I gotta say, I like them too. But the article that I read this week said that alcohol fuels creativity. And that's probably not a surprise to you. But according to the research that was done, it was discovered that alcohol helps to make you more decisive. You will come to a conclusion faster than you would if you were sober. Sober, you might be a little more involved in the process of determining the answer, whereas when you're drunk, you just go boom, that's the answer, there it is. You don't have to think about it. You become more instinctive perhaps with a little bit of alcohol in you. So I thought that was kind of interesting, and I know for a fact that I never would have been able to have this car built the way I wanted it to, or taken the risk that I have without a drink once in a while. And I'm not completely blitzed, but I am having a little difficulty getting some of my words out, which is usually a problem when I'm sober anyway. But when I have a drink, it's a little more difficult. I can still enunciate, at least as well as a New Jersey guy can anyway. Those of you might be laughing at that, of course, but you know, I don't mind. But let's stay on this project here. Let's try to get as much done as we can today. I'm doing really, really well. And some of the stuff that I was concerned wasn't going to get done is getting done, and quickly. So let's stay on it. And see where we wind up at the end of the day. Here we go. Doop. We'll be right back.
All right, I promised that I would show you this rear hatch. There it is, fresh hot cat piss. But something I didn't finish was installing these latches on here. Now, you remember last November it was when I was working on this. But these hatch releases, everything's been soaking in acid, by the way, so things are a little sticky while the iron phosphate starts to settle in. So I can get up in here and there's a little too much acid in there. Just wipe that out. I'm not too worried about phosphoric acid on the skin. It's not really reactive with human tissue. I mean, it might be, but it's not particularly strong. By the time I get inside to rinse it off, it won't have anything done to me unless I do something stupid like wipe my eyes. You can see the latches in there now. And then down below here, you can see it, the little pieces that the latches will lock into. I also created the notches back here, so that way the flappers for the hatch will fit right in there. And then with the latches in the open position, everything closes the way it's supposed to. Lock it, fold the little loops down, just like a factory bus hatch. And I mean, look how good that looks. It looks like it belongs in there, and actually, it does. I can't wait for this to be painted. It's actually going to be standard color scheme as it would be on a bus, which I believe this thing is just painted black. So we're gonna do that just the same. I don't see any reason to do anything custom with that because, well, it's supposed to look like it's stock. All right, well, that turned out great. I'm gonna leave this open just to let the phosphoric acid dry. That's down inside of there. That was something that I never got to do last winter. I just kind of forgot about it, you know, and you move on to the next piece of the project, and I came back to it. I'm glad I got that done today. Up here, we also got these all squared away now. You notice all the welds all the way around it are all finished. And I've also got the one on this side done too. And you can see that one's all filled in just the same. They're all ground down already, also soaked in phosphoric acid. So those patches are ready to rock and roll. All right, let's go ahead and wrap up this video. It's getting late. Well, we got a lot done today. You probably noticed the audio quality change. That's because my microphone died. Like a fool last night, I only charged the receiver portion of it and not the actual microphone that's attached to my ass over here, this thing. So anyway, the receiver was running and the other pieces did. Anyway, we did really well over here. We got all this welded in, we got that welded in, and that's ground off. The bottom we're gonna grind off tomorrow. It's getting a little late, so I think it's just a little obnoxious to start grinding here at 8:30 at night. The dashboard is all patched. The rear hatch is all patched. I got that all straightened, ready to go. This is ready for the door to be hung on it. I also fine-tuned the hinges a little bit today and got those set up and squared away, ready to go. So all I've got to do then is grind that down, shove that door right in, it's good to go. And then we're going to drop that hood onto place, and I'm going to drill the holes for the hood handle because the hood, I don't know its history. It came from another car, and somebody apparently welded closed the holes where the handle goes. So I'm going to drill them back out and put the handle back on it. But like I said, I think that's it for tonight. So thanks a lot, guys, for watching. Really do appreciate it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, pluck that dingle bell, and you get updates every time I upload a video. Check out duckshit.net, which is my website. All of my different social media links are up there, and if you'd like to buy some of my merch, I don't know what I do with my shirt. I guess I put it back inside. duckshit.net/store. Visit the store, buy a DuckmanCycles t-shirt or a Skeeter the Duck t-shirt. Hey, I also have Eleanor t-shirts. And I'm thinking down the road, probably every couple months, I'm going to be creating some new designs. Now, Earl will be getting this car sometime in the next couple weeks, so check out duckshit.net/CCC. That will forward you directly to Earl's channel. You need to subscribe. I can't stress that enough. Otherwise, you're not going to see the following progress on this car as soon as it goes over there. And like I said, it's going to be there really soon, really soon. As soon as my work schedule clears up, I'm just going to just throw this thing on and get out of here as fast as I can and get it down to him. So it's not a scheduled thing. It's just going to happen when it happens. And when it happens, you guys are going to miss it if you're not subscribed to Earl. Once again, duckshit.net/CCC. Subscribe to Earl. Do it immediately. Classic Car Creations. That's his channel. Anyways, thanks guys for watching. Really appreciate it. As always, we'll see you next time.